Kia ora and welcome to this short video on simple concentration calculations for the 91161 standard. And this is the formula we're going to use. C is equal to N over V. Think of a carrot with the N and the V of the carrot, an orange for C, concentration. So let's look at this problem. Calculate the amount of HNO3 required to make 3 liters of a 0.250 moles per liter solution. So as we did last time, think of what you are given and what you have to work out. So you have to work out the amount of nitric acid, and that's in moles. You are given the volume and you are given the concentration. Now you know it's concentration because of the units. So make sure you know the units of all the different quantities. Concentrations, mole per liter, volume, liter, amount, mole. Now we use the C is equal to N over V equation, and notice that N is on the right hand side associated with V, whereas we are trying to calculate N. So we need to get N by itself. So the way to do that is to say, right, I must get rid of the V's on the right hand side. So I multiply this by V, and you can see the V's have cancelled out. But whatever I do to one side of the equation, I have to do to the other side. So you can see I now have N is equal to C times V. And if I want to bring this N across to the left-hand side, I just swap the two sides over and I substitute. So it's 0.25 times 3. And notice my units of liters will cancel out, leaving me with the correct units of mole. And notice I give the answer to 3 significant figures because the measured values were given to 3 significant figures. Let's try a different problem where we're going to use the C equals N over V formula or equation, as well as the N is equal to the small m over big M. So let's look at this. We have to calculate the mass. So first divide your page into 2. So do everything with the C is equal to N over V on this side, and everything to do with N is equal to small m over big M on the right-hand side. Now we have to calculate the mass, so that goes onto the mass side of the equation. And what else are we given? We are given a volume. Now notice it is in milliliters. And we are given a concentration. So to get from this side to that side, I always use the moles, the amount, and because I'm dealing with the same substance, I don't have to use a mole ratio. So I have to calculate now the amount. So I use this formula that we worked out just now, N is equal to C times V, substitute into it. Now notice my quick shortcut I've done to change from milliliters to liters. I have simply multiplied by 10 to the minus 3. That is the same as dividing by 1,000. Remember, 1 milliliter is smaller than a liter. So if you're changing from milliliters to liters, the number must become smaller. And that is my amount in moles. So I use this now on the right-hand side, my amount in moles. Work out the molar mass. So for magnesium nitrate, I have 1 magnesium, 24.3. I have 2 nitrogen atoms, so it's 2 times 14. And I have 6 oxygen atoms, because I've got 2 nitrates in total. So I have to multiply the 16 by 6, and I get this answer of 148.3 grams per mole. Right. I must work out mass. I have molar mass. I have moles. I have N, I have big M, and I can now calculate little m. So little m is equal to N times big M, just swapping that equation around. Substitute into it. These are all the figures in my calculator, plus some more, but because I have been given it in 3 significant figures, although I must admit that is 2, but we'll leave it as 3. So give your answer to 3 significant figures and write out everything so it's clear what you have calculated. Right, all the best. Goodbye.